My real job here is to welcome everybody. I grew up in, or was born in Washington, D.C. And the X, if there's an X for me, is I'm actually working on governance. And what does it mean when you have the world connected together, and what can you do with society, with the kind of information resources and all the things that we're doing? In fact, I'm writing a book on that subject. The inspiration for this whole process came from two basically crazy and wonderful people, Astro and Megan. They think of themselves as the cruise directors, and they think of themselves as really sort of sponsoring this. And I think that they represent, in many ways, the best of Google. And in our conversations, the notion was maybe we can use Google's name and perhaps convening authority to try to make a difference in the world. We have in the room, of course, Ram Shriram, who's representing our board. Ram is over there. Sergey, of course, who, frankly, the entire Google X, almost everything you see, obviously the company as well, I guess, by derivative induction, would not exist. And he has been a genuine champion of real innovation. And, of course, we have a couple of other people. Sebastian Thrun is here. Where's Sebastian there? Who actually is running sort of a large part of this. We're trying to do things differently from other people. We're trying to do innovation differently. We're trying to think about it. When I sit down and I talk to Larry and Sergey, sort of the greatest partnership of my life professionally, obviously, is that every time I say something which I think is pretty interesting, they say, you're not thinking broad enough. You're not thinking new enough. You're not thinking different enough. I think they were like this when they were children. That's the only way I can describe. So when I was thinking about this, I remember something that Peter Diamandis told me, and you probably don't remember this, Peter, but Peter, and again, he has his own X, called the X Prize, of course, he said that life is who you travel with, and that stuck me, because I thought that maybe what I should do is organize to travel my professional life through the people who I find most interesting, and the people that I find most interesting, modeled after Larry and Sergey, are people who want to change the world, who have the chutzpah or the arrogance or the genius or the just craziness to think that they can do it, and that they need some help. And by the way, the help they need is encouragement. They need somebody to believe in them. They need to believe that somehow this thing can happen. And so the principle that we established around this event and bringing you all together is that there was safety in numbers, that if we could find other people like you. And remember, we called you, and everyone that we called said yes. That's an important principle. So we understood that we were trying to put together a group and a team of people who knew what they wanted to do, they could use some help, maybe we could help them a little bit along the way to changing the world. So in this particular formulation, which I think is the defining problem of innovation at level, what you see is you see hope for America. You see hope for the Western world. You see hope for Asia. It is up to us to invent the solutions that will solve the world's problems. In this particular group, we have representatives of what we think, in our sort of humble judgment, represent some of the biggest opportunities that either are in front of us or problems that we're creating by virtue of the things that we're doing. If in a small way, we, Google, representing what we hope is excellence and commitment, if we can help you along the way, we will have done our job. Our contribution is small, yours is large. Our commitment is to popularize your ideas, try to figure out a way to take this. This is a very important event. This is a founding concept of our thinking about these things. If this works, you can help us figure out a way to scale this. Something of concept. When I talked to Larry, who's not here tonight, but is hoping to be here tomorrow, Larry says, I don't want to do just research. I want to do research that makes something happen. I don't want to do writing that just people read. I want the writing to lead to action. Right? And I thought, Sergey, maybe you could add a little bit representing Larry as well. From my perspective, we've been looking for this, looking forward for you all to be here for months. So this is a really big day for us. Sergey, thanks.
Thank you very much, Eric, for that eloquent introduction. And we've certainly, Larry and I, well, I would say Larry is really the ambitious one of the three of us. But I think I've taken a bit of that with me from spending so much time with him, and now Eric has too. I'm very excited to be working in technology, particularly at this time. And one thing that I was just remembered, I was just sitting with Peter here at dinner, Peter DeMontis, who some of you might know from the XPRIZE. Several years ago, we were together in Baikonur in Kazakhstan to see a Soyuz launch.
Do you really want to tell him that story?
Really, it was very, very close. And
well, let's just say that the Russian guard through the interpreter, Sergey understood Russian, said, if the rocket blows up, we're all dead. And Sergey said, sure!
And we were all foolish enough to go on this adventure. It was incredibly close. Like, we went, drove in toward this rocket, and there were hundreds of people all going the other way. and that, by the way, that was really an astonishing sight. If you ever have the opportunity, I highly recommend it. It's really not at all comparable, at least to the American launches that I've seen, because those are like 5 miles away behind a mountain. And in Russia, they're not as concerned with safety. But the reason I'm reminded of that, aside from that risk-taking, is because we stopped in a museum there they had, and there was an old computer. It was sort of like a Russian copy of an ENIAC or something. Charles Simony, who was with us, who was, I guess, the only two-time space tourist, pointed out to us its different parts, and we took out one of its vacuum tubes, which was like a one-bit flip-flop or something. I was really struck by that, because then I pulled apart my phone, took out the micro SD card, which was 16 gigabytes, put it up next to it, and I took a photo at that time. So that was 16 gigabytes, so about 100 billion times more data, and it was tiny, like you could barely see it on this vacuum tube. We all live Moore's Law, we all believe it, understand it, but to see that physical difference right in front of me, that was pretty astonishing. The opportunity to really to be able to use that difference. I mean, that's what we've done with Google, with the various, be it search or Gmail or things like that, where we can deploy amazing computational power, just searching through all the world's knowledge in fractions of a second. That's thanks to those advances in technology and thanks to Moore's Law. That's been incredible to watch happen. And now to see, well, where does that take us next? And how much computational capability does each of our phones in our pockets have? Sorry, I left mine over there. But I'm sure each of you has an incredibly powerful computer, even by the standards of the computers that we started operating Google on, by the servers that we used 10 years ago. Today, you have something far more capable in your pocket. That's really astounding, and the applications of that are incredible too, I believe. We have our own sort of ventures that are a bit of moonshots. I mentioned one during dinner, which is our autonomous vehicles, and that's really exciting to be able to use technology to really liberate people. If you think of, aside from all of us who have to deal with daily commutes and things like that, the people who are either disabled or too old or too young, for them to be able to get around in their life, it's just incredible to see the impact that technology can have. So I'm super excited to see all of you here. I had a chance to talk to a few of you now about all of your respective moonshots. And it's amazing to me, the creativity, the ambition, and I'm really looking forward to learning from all of you. Thank you.
Let us define X. X is a solution to a seemingly insurmountable problem, like climate change or cancer, one that affects the world. But what if we redefine X as a challenge, an opportunity for radical thinking, a chance to light up the world with breakthrough ideas and cutting-edge technology, the stuff of science fiction that just might fly after all? Solving for X requires wonder and imagination and the vision to build seemingly impossible solutions to the world's biggest problems. Solve for X. Moonshot thinking.